In this case, Cheryl was nominated by one of our cage supervisors, Mary Lynn Huber. Cheryl is another one of our long-term employees. She's been here quite a long time. But you'd never know it because you never know she's here. She's very quiet. But the guests keep coming to her window. They love her. She does a fantastic job. You never hear anything bad about her. She's so good that she's almost part of the woodwork. I hate to say that, but I mean, she's quiet. She gets the job done. She does a fantastic job. She's on. She doesn't make mistakes. But this time she actually did something that got her even more recognized, something more fantastic. It's something that's not in your job description, as Steve was saying, not my job. That was what Cheryl did here. Back in August, we had a supervisor, Mary Lynn, was in the main bank. And foolishly, she put her foot up on one of the drawers in the cage to tie her shoe. And in that process, she fell over and hit her head. And she was down for a little bit. And actually, she was down for a while. They ended up taking her out and whisking her away. But Cheryl was right there. Cheryl was working in the main bank. The moment she went down, she was there. She made sure she was taken care of. She covered her up. We've got some smocks in there that we used to go into the count room. She got some of those, covered her up so that she stayed warm. She kept her calm, kept her from moving so that if there was any injuries that it was taken care of. She just, did everything that you're supposed to do when you have an emergency. And that, nobody's ready for it. It's not in your job description. And nobody says you have to do it. In fact, in today's world, how many times do people walk by somebody that's laying on the ground? And Cheryl took it out of her time to, make sure that Mary Lynn was taken care of, that she was comfortable, that by time security got there with the rescue crew, that they were able to make sure that she hadn't moved and done anything more wrong. And I just know that for Mary Lynn, that she is eternally grateful to Cheryl, and so are we, because it's that kind heart that makes her special. So thank you, Cheryl.